brought this to the summer place, and I spent nights looking at it and psyching out how the program worked. And wow, I figured out how this it worked, and that's how they can look at an algebraic formula and convert it into instruction. But then it was terrible style. The program was kludgy. You read it, and every time they would do something, they did it the hard way. I look at the SOAP program, the one that came by Stan Poley. It was elegant. It was beautiful. It was like hearing a symphony. It was whenever it did an instruction, the instruction was sort of accomplishing two things at once. Everything fit together harmoniously. It was elegant code. I said, boy, I'd love to write programs like this guy can do. And conversely, you know, this clunky code that came from the other one, I can do better than that. So a couple of friends and I wrote an improvement of it, which we called RUNCIBLE. Every program had to have an acronym in those days, and RUNCIBLE was Revised Unified New Compiler IT Basic Language Extended or something. We had some reason for the word RUNCIBLE, but mainly we wanted to redo that algebraic language in a way that was more elegant and have more features, and so we could improve it in lots of ways and still stay within our 10K bytes, and so that was how I spent my first summer at the computer center. It turned out that after RUNCIBLE was done, we also I wrote a user's manual for how to write, how to use this the program, curiously, this user's manual was then used as a textbook for students the next year, so I was in the unusual position of taking a class for which I had written the textbook when I was a sophomore, one of my classes in computing. RUNCIBLE, we revised it the next summer and made it really lots of bells and whistles, still with our 10K bytes, but we got a floating point attachment, and we had some other things. My friends and I came up with better versions. So here this I also wrote a SOAP 3. You know, I love this SOAP 2 program we had from IBM. I wrote SOAP 3, which improved on SOAP 2, and this was used as the assembler program for our other software development that we were doing. So here are cases allowing about a dozen of us undergrads to write software that's being used by the other students and faculty of CASE. And Fred Way, who was the director of this program, was very foresighted, able to trust the students and we had lots of fun talking to each other about all these issues, and we knew literature of journals. The communications of the ACM started up in 1958. All of a sudden, we saw that there were people publishing ideas from other parts of the world about how to write programs, and we knew that we had already discovered a lot of these things too, and we had some better slants on it. So, my second technical publication after Potchefstroom System for Mad Magazine, my second technical publication was about this RUNCIBLE, the method we used in RUNCIBLE to do the conversion of formulas into machine code, and here I sent it to this magazine, the Communication of the ACM, which we had just begun to come out, and I was totally naive, not understanding anything about scientific journals or publication or conventions. I had been seeing magazines. I knew what magazines were and so on. But no people. But there was no idea of credit or something like this. It was just the story that was important. And so when I wrote this up, I considered myself to be a spokesman, for these guys at Case Computing Center who had been working together to create RUNCIBLE. And I wrote an article about the methods that are used in RUNCIBLE. Nowhere in the article did I mention the names of these other guys who had been working on it. I didn't know that I was going to be getting credit for any of these ideas. I just wanted to describe the ideas. And so this was I learned later all about scientific conventions and publication. But I was just a journalist, and I was treating the story as that. We set the story right when the article was published as part of my collected works a couple of years ago.